Good evening, and welcome to Atlantic Cape Community College and the 12th Annual Communication Awards. While we will appreciate it if you silence your phones at this time, we encourage you to take lots of pictures and post them on the Atlantic Cape Communication Facebook page. And now, to start our program, please welcome the Vice President of the Communication Club, Jennifer Johnston.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the 12th Annual Atlantic Cape Communication Awards. This show is organized and run by the Communication Club in order to recognize those who have exceeded their potential in communication classes throughout the year. The communication program is different from other programs. Between the lessons you learn, the experiences you gather, and the friends you make, the communication program proves to encourage growth throughout every individual. Many communication majors find that the friends that they make in these classes are friends that stay with them for life. There are also mentors, which are typically alumni, who attend the various communication classes in order to help those in those classes. What other major does that? Communication is one of the hardest yet most important tools you will need to succeed in life, no matter what your job may be. Many students dread taking public speaking. I know that because I put off it for as long as I possibly could. These classes are critically important, and honoring the achievements of those receiving awards tonight should be valued as a wonderful success. During this award ceremony, you will see performances from five different individuals who are attempting to become Communication Major of the Year. And this can only happen by your vote. After the five individuals have taken the stage, you will get to choose which one you think should be Communication Major of the Year. This individual will be a leader, a mentor, and a great friend. This person will continue to grow in the communication program, encourage others in the program, and help achieve success for those who ask for help. Tonight, we will also be honoring high school faculty pioneers, David Von Rome and Charles Garrison. Pete Thompson is attending tonight as a guest speaker with the hopes of encouraging those in the communication program to keep shooting for their dreams. I would like to personally thank Asia Alexander and Demetrius Lesson for putting the music together that you hear for tonight's show. It is because of their hard work and dedication that you're able to hear everything that plays. At this time, I would like to call to this stage the ninth president of Atlantic Cape, Dr. Bob Argabra.
See you tonight, and thank you for attending the 12th Annual Communications Awards Ceremony sponsored by Atlantic Cape's Communication Club. There are over 50 awards being presented tonight, with a great number of deserving nominees in the running. The Communication Awards are a highlight of the academic year and showcase the talents of our students, alumni, faculty, and media professionals. To all of tonight's student nominees, again, congratulations. Your nomination shows that you have a talent and passion for your work. These qualities are essential to your success in college and in life. If you keep up the hard work, what you can achieve is truly limitless. Your efforts make Atlantic Cape an institution of excellence, and we are honored to celebrate your achievements with you tonight. I would like to recognize the faculty, staff, alumni, and pioneers. We commend you for your achievements in the field, and we are very grateful for the time and effort you have given to the college and to our students. Thank you to all the faculty, staff, and students who are recognized, especially the Communications Club, who sponsored this event, and to the founder, alumna Jenna DeLuca, one of tonight's hosts. The Communication Club officers are Don Donnelly, the president, Jennifer Johnston, vice president, Christine Birchtoll, secretary, Jack Crowell, treasurer, Annie Becker, PR director, Evan Fisher, SGA representative, and Professor Keith Forrest and Jenny Thomas, advisors. Thank you also to Dr. Joy Jones-Cormack, Professor Rich Russell, the Student Government Association, and all of those who volunteered for the event tonight. And I want to thank our host, Briar Gibbons, President of the Communication Alumni Council, Chris Devine, Vice President of Communication Alumni Council, and Jenna DeLuca, the founding president of the Communication Club. We are so proud of our alumni, and we thank them all for coming back to the college. In closing, I'd like to welcome you again to Atlantic Cape. Good luck to all of the nominees tonight, and congratulations to the students on this spectacular event. At this time, we have three Communication alumni who will be your hosts this evening. Please join me in welcoming to the stage Brian Gibbons, Chris Devine, and Jenna DeLuca.
Hello, everybody. My name is Briar Gibbons. I graduated from Atlantic Cape in 2014, and I'm the current president of the Communication Alumni Council.
My name is Chris Devine. I graduated from Atlantic Cape in 2016, and I am the current vice president of the Communication Alumni Council.
Hi, my name is Jenna DeLuca, and I graduated in 2017, and I am the founding president of the Communication Club and a member at large of the Communication Alumni Council.
Tonight, we will be presenting awards in over 40 categories, including public speaking, public relations, creative writing, pop music, and film history. We will also be honoring students, faculty, staff, alumni, and industry professionals for their contributions in the field of communication.
But most importantly, this night belongs to Atlantic Cape's talented communication students, and I ask that can all award winners now please stand, and let's recognize them for all their accomplishments with a huge round of applause.
At this time, Group 1, please begin lining up. Now please join me in welcoming your first Communication Major of the Year nominee, Evan Fisher.
Oh, hello, I'm Evan. And I'm glad you all came out of here tonight to support the communication department of Atlantic Cape Community College. Now, you're, of course, going to vote on who will be the next communication major of the year. And with that position comes a lot of responsibility. So in order for you to make an informed decision, I'm here to tell you a bit about myself. First, I'm going to talk about myself personally, then my academic career, and then lastly, what I would do if I were given the opportunity to become the Communication Major of the Year. In regards to myself, I have high-functioning autism. And while people have told me that I've struggled in the past, not because of this or in spite of this, but just through many different things, I've never seen it as anything else than just part of me, where while some people would say I've struggled, I don't notice it as a struggle because I've not seen anything else, so it all seems relatively easy to me. That is, except for early education. I had a very difficult time in elementary and middle school and early high school, to where subjects like math and science I knew and could understand. If on standardized testing, I would score some of the highest like points in my grade, but then when it came to the class, I didn't get the concept even of homework, or I would not study for tests and not understand specific minutiae of the answers. This would all change in high school when I would be able to get into my high school's film department. I would go initially to Mainland, and by being in their media production department, I was finally able to realize that I completely understood communication. Film, radio, television, short stories, any fiction. It all completely made sense to me, so much so that I eventually would transfer from Mainland to Charter Tech and work my way up through their film and television department to become a member of the advanced class. And through all of this, I was able to realize that I can hyper-focus and fully understand just the entire concept of communication, and it is It's all I kind of want to do and need to do. And this would eventually kind of lead me to a kind of vacant spot to where after graduating, I didn't know what to do. I wasn't aware that you had to like go to colleges. I just assumed that colleges came and said like, we like you, so come here. So when I graduated high school, I was kind of like looking around and I was like, so what happens now? And nothing happened for quite a while. Until eventually I was like, all right, I'll start a bit. I guess community college, that's an easy way to begin. And I came here and I was completely blown away by what I found. I did not expect the communication department to actually be the weight and healthiness of what it was. To where every single thing I've learned here has been exactly what I needed to know or I've been personally accustomed to. All throughout middle school and high school, I think the second or third grade was the last time I had gotten A's or B's consistently throughout my marking period. Since I've come here, I have not gotten through a semester without A's or B's. And it is entirely because, It's entirely because this department allows me to focus on what I am good at and get better at it without having to worry about too many other distractions because this department is so well built and well functioning. But there are some improvements I would like to see. First of all is that kind of gap where I was in a bit of a void of not knowing what to do, I would like to remedy for other people in my situation. Going to schools' media departments and their film departments and saying, not just completely ACC as an option, but this communication department is something special compared to other things. A lot of my friends went to Stockton, and to not offend any Stockton attendees in the audience, but they were like, yeah, you can do movie stuff there, but it's fine, I guess. While looking here, I was really kind of blown away by what I'm able to learn and able to do. I mean, like, that's here tonight is what we are able to do, and just a small fraction of it. But with regards to other changes, I don't know many other people in the communication department. There are people in other clubs and classes that I've never met, and for the like, there are faces in the audience that you might be in the same major as me, but I don't recognize you just because we've never crossed paths. So if I were a communication major, not only would I wish to get more interaction with high school, but get more interaction between the different clubs. We have musicians, actors, filmmakers, writers, all together in the same campus, but we don't cross over with each other enough. We don't mingle and create synergy to create art or projects. And I'd love if we were able to host events throughout semesters where multiple clubs from the different sub-departments of the communication department were able to get together and create things that are worthy of the communication field and ACCC as a whole. So now that you know all about that, I hope you are able to then weigh my opinions and beliefs and judgments against the other people that are running and vote for whoever you think is the best. So thank you.
Hi, my name is Rich Russell. I'm an assistant professor of English here at the college. For over 20 years, the heart of the creative writing program here at the college was Professor Jerry Black, who taught creative writing classes, who helped to host poets and writers on campus, and who advised our literary magazine. Our literary magazine Rewrites, now in its 37th year. Jerry was the and there are copies available in the lobby. Jerry was the advisor of Rewrites when I was the student editor of the magazine, and I feel privileged to be able to continue Jerry's work as the current advisor for Rewrites. Those of us who serve as advisors know that the work that takes place within these extracurricular spaces is just as important, if not more so, than the work we do in the classroom. Jerry understood this. She was my teacher, my mentor, and my friend. In the fall, the publications office in the new student center just next door will be named in memory of Jerry, and the English department will host a dedication ceremony and reading in Jerry's honor. In her writing, Jerry always understood the profound importance of place, In her work as a teacher, she understood the significance of this place, and so it feels right to name a room for Jerry here so that her memory can be a sanctuary for creative introverts like me who always saw her as a safe haven. Now students who never knew Jerry will take comfort in the space we named for her. Before her death, Jerry established an endowment which each year provides a scholarship to one of our writing students. This year's scholarship will be awarded to Denise Marco later this month, a student in my Honors Composition 2 class right now and an English major. Congratulations, Denise. 7 years ago, the communication program voted to rename the Creative Writing Awards in honor of Jerry. Jerry was here at that ceremony when the first Jerry Black Awards were given out. I know how humbled she was to receive that honor. It's very humbling for me, too, to be asked to give out these awards tonight to some brilliant writers who will be reading and discussing their work at our 8th annual Writers Colloquium on Tuesday, May 7th at 12:30 in the library's art gallery. And you are all invited back to campus to attend the Writers Colloquium on Tuesday at 12:30. These students in their writing teach us how to smile, how to suffer, and how to survive. And so now my friend Breyer will present to you the winners of the 7th annual Jerry Black Creative Writing Awards.
Best Creative Nonfiction, Corinne Errico. Best Fiction, Sarah Schreiber and McKenna Olson. Best Poetry, Dylan Clark. Best Play, Jennifer Johnston and Jacob Vitale. Thank you, everyone. You may now exit the stage. Best Screenplay, Ethan Gabriz. Best Cross-Genre, Gabrielle Brandenberger and Rin Doe. Best Creative Writing, Mary Ellen Neese. Rewrites, Alyssa Cole. Thank you, everyone. You may now exit the stage. Group two, please begin to line up. And at this time, please welcome your second nominee for Communication Major of the Year, Gianna Malgieri.
Hello, my name is Gianna Malgieri. I feel very honored to be one of the nominees for this year's Communication Major of the Year. I'm going to spend a few minutes telling you why I feel like I am the ideal candidate. Growing up, I didn't have the most ideal childhood. My dad, who has since passed, was never a part of my life. I never really had a father figure. And in 2008, when my mom remarried, we went through an 8-year period of domestic violence. But it's not something to be sad about. It's something that we learned from. And there were three things that got us through a difficult time. The first and foremost is the grace of God. We would not have been able to get through what we endured without the grace of God. The other two things are things that I think that we can bring to the communication program. Those two things are open communication and honesty. During this whole period, we were very honest with each other about what was going on, and we always talked about our feelings, and we made it very clear to each other, and we were there for each other. And that made the process a lot easier than if we had been alone. And I think we'll see the same results if we brought those two qualities here to the communication program. If we have that open communication and that transparency, I think we'll see the same results. if I were to be elected as Communication Major of the Year, I really want to focus on high school recruitment. Too many times, and myself included, I hear people say, I didn't even know we had this communication program here. I didn't even know. And I think it's up to us. You know, every Friday when we don't have class, we can get students together, my friends and people in the communication club, we can get everyone together and bring them to the high schools, bring them and talk to the students directly and tell them what we have here at this program. Help them plant the seed to realize we can come to Atlantic Cape to start our communication degree. My ultimate goal is to become an NFL sideline reporter. That's my ultimate goal. And I believe that here, I believe that I am getting the communication, or the education, I'm sorry, the education I'm receiving here is exactly what I need to be on the right path. Thank you. Now, if you look at your ballot, my name's Gianna Malgeri. If you look at your ballot, I am the last name. I'm the last name on the list, and yes, my last name has a scribble underneath because no, Microsoft Word does not know my Italian last name.
Thank you, Gianna, for that wonderful presentation. At this time, I would like to present the awards for interpersonal communication. Best interpersonal group, Gianna, Dominique Banks, Joanna Noto, Anna Samanik, Sheena Sosa, Lexi Maddow. The award for interpersonal achievement, Emmanuel Dan, Laura Laporte, thank you. You may exit the stage. During my time at Atlantic Cape, I was lucky enough to cross paths with educators who would change my life forever. Among them was Joy Jones. Dr. Joy Jones Carmack, I hear that, shout out to Joy Jones. Dr. Joy Jones Carmack served as Assistant Professor of Communication here at Atlantic Cape beginning in 2006 and remained at the college until spring of 2017. She then made the difficult decision to transition over to Stockton University as Assistant Professor of Business Studies Management. Outside of the classroom, Dr. Jones is striving to change the world through communication. She can often be found speaking in various venues, providing executive coaching or corporate training, as well as writing and conducting research. Dr. Jones has spent many semesters working hard alongside of Professor Keith Forrest to help build this program into what it is today. She also dedicated her time into helping out with this very event alongside of what was once known as the Communication Awards Committee, as well as planning the annual public speaking competition. Although Dr. Jones has moved on to the next phase of her career, her legacy at Atlantic Cape lives on. I will now present the Joy Jones Carmack Awards. Best PR Group Project, Alexandria Obert. Mike Lewis. Annalise Davis. Laura DeBlois. Woo!
Laura DeBlois is also receiving the award for Best PR Practitioner. Best Press Release, Nick Rollins. All right, thank you, everyone. You may now exit the stage. At this time, please welcome your group three. Before someone yells at me, group three, please line up. At this time, please welcome your third nominee for Communication Major of the Year, Rachel Dougherty.
So, seeing as I've already been introduced, I would like to offer a flashback to Ocean City High School graduating class of 2016 for a visual representation of how prepared I was for college. Not at all. Not even a little bit. You can actually feel the fear in my expression in this picture, actually. I enrolled at Atlantic Cape that fall as a nursing major. Clearly that is not still the case. During that first year, I craved something to be passionate about. I longed for positive change in my life. Being a first-generation college student, I had no idea how to find out which major was right for me, other than trial and error. About 5 times of trial and error is what it took, each time a different major. With no role model or guide, college became stressful very quickly. I guess you could say I had a Britney moment during that time. But around that time, I stumbled upon the communication major, but by the time I'd switched it, my scholarship had run its course, and financial difficulties forced me to take a gap year and get my first job. The picture on the left was my first month at McDonald's, and the picture on the right was my 9th month at McDonald's. During my gap year, I feel that I'd found what being a communication major means to me. Through doing things that I love, from being a camp counselor to spending time with my friends, I found that being a communication major means to set aside differences to work together, and that, of course, conflict resolution came along with it. And being one of 6 siblings teaches you that very quickly. During my gap year, I actually attended the Communication Awards last year. And seeing everyone display their talents and public speaking abilities made me realize that this is something I want to be a part of. And from that day on, I decided that I wanted to go back to college, and so I did. With the determination to fully immerse myself, I quickly became involved in many different clubs, such as the Atlantic Cape Review Newspaper Club, Rewrites, the Literary Magazine, Pride Club, and of course, Communication Club. But I was still confused as to what sets communication apart from other majors until, during a meeting, during a meeting with Professor Forrest, I'd realized that I already had the answers to my questions through my experiences in the past year. And it almost feels as if communication was predestined for me. As a child, my parents lovingly nicknamed me Motor Mouth, and talking has always come naturally to me. It's a trait that I really admire about myself. But why Communication Major of the Year? To put it simply, I want to be the person that I didn't have during my last year of high school or my first year at Atlantic Cape. This major has become my passion, and I've fallen in love with communication. As Communication Major of the Year, I hope to share that love with other confused high school and college students. So, going back to 2016, I offer a quote that still resonates with me, as it did in that scared 18-year-old girl. From my graduation cap and the great pop punk band Fall Out Boy, "You are what you love, not who loves you. Thank you."
Thank you so much for your presentation, Rachel. We will now present to you the winners in public speaking. Best call to action speech, Reese Anchetta, Michael Ferreri, Jacqueline Lichtenberger, Thayer Noble, Maya Varela, and Matthew DiMartino. Thank you, everyone. You may now exit the stage.
And now for the awards for honors public speaking, Jess Badger. Dylan Clark. Ryan Emmer. And Valerie Myland. The awards for best informative speech, Sam Blackman. Jalen Hudgens. Zachary Katzen. And Katrina Vidal. Thank you, everyone. You may now exit the stage.
For best persuasive speech, Carl Brown, Kimberly Contouris, Melissa Evans, Chancellor Harding,
Rochelle Jackson, Marita Kojai, Alexandra Palacio. I got it. Brian Ross. Megan Sacco. And Amber Roan. Thank you, everyone. You may now exit the stage.
At this time, we will ask that group four please begin to line up. Please give a warm welcome to our fourth Communication Major of the Year nominee, Maria Gonzalez.
Hello and good evening. My name is Maria Gonzalez. Before I say why I would like to be Communications Major of the Year, I believe it's vital that I explain how I got here at Atlantic Cape Community College. I'm grateful to be here and honored to be on this stage sharing my story. But to do that rightfully, I have to be perfectly honest. Community college was not my first option. In 2017, when I first signed up for classes in the fall semester, I did so 1 week before classes started. In my mind at the time, enrolling to community college was my last resort. I knew I wanted to go to a four-year college with my entire being. I knew I wanted to major in film, and I did not see community college as the first step in taking me where I wanted to be. My lack of knowledge and understanding was keeping me from seeing my full opportunity. With my father passing away while I was a baby, my mother did not have the opportunity to attend college. Being a first-generation college student was tough since my family didn't know how to fully support me, and my high school failed to give me the proper resources. My family was there for me, but their help wasn't everything I needed for my transition between high school to college. I am proud of myself and where I am today. but I felt like I did not get the correct counseling from my guidance counselor or teachers at school. Everyone is so focused on going to a four-year college that we overlook the great opportunity that we have here in Cape May and Atlantic counties. That being said, I have a plan to change the agenda. As potential communication major of the year, I would like to firsthand talk to high school students from both counties and give them the understanding they need in considering their college options, and to help broaden their understanding of community college. This would not only promote our school, but specifically help promote our communications department. More importantly, I believe it will give students the understanding and guidance they need when making important decisions about their future. I also believe that as a college student, personally reaching out to a high school student would be comfortable for them. Seeing a table set up about the communications department with a person similar to their age would help them more likely to reach out. If they have a question about the courses, awesome. I've taken them. Or a question about creative writing, I took that last spring, and I have plenty of helpful information to share. College is a nerve-wracking experience, but it feels less frightening when you have someone there for you. Someone who knows exactly what journey you're about to embark on, with firsthand experience and knowledge with the courses and professors they're about to take. My goal as Communications Major of the Year is to be a helping hand to the communications majors that will be here after I leave. Although I didn't have the information and guidance the future students can be provided with, I was still able to begin my academic journey here at Atlantic Cape Community College. But experiences like mine are far and few between. We have the power to change that here, now, at Atlantic Cape Community College. My only hope now is to provide future communication enrollees with the knowledge they need to see their future as exciting and not overwhelming, in hopes that they can have a smooth college transition here at Atlantic Cape Community College. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Maria, for your presentation. At this time, we will present the awards for pop music, journalism, and performing arts. Best Pop Music Project, Bud Burgess. Jennifer Johnston. Chrissy Montalbano. Frank Sapinaire. Dan Brown. Dan Brown is also receiving the award for Best Pop Music Paper. Thank you. You may exit the stage.
Now the award for for Pop Music Achievement, Meg Clark. Best Feature Story, Jennifer Johnston. For Best Sports Story, Gianna Malgieri. The Theater Arts Guild Award, Jennifer Lewis. The Choir Award, John Martin Jr. And the Atlantic Cape Review Award goes to Brian Ross.
Thank you. You may exit the stage. At this time, please welcome our fifth Communication Major of the Year nominee, Jalen Hudgens. Everyone saying how they can't wait for the OP. And I'm gonna blow.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, I would like to say, can we have a hand for the rest of the nominees tonight? Weren't they wonderful? Also, I would like to thank the people who put this together. I would like to thank Professor Forrest. I would like to thank thank Ms. Jenny Thomas. I would like to thank everybody that's here tonight and is taking into consideration possibly voting for me. So, so basically what I want to say is, you know, I don't really like to talk about myself too much because that doesn't feel humble of me. So I'd rather show you instead. And by doing so, I hope to bring you into my world a little bit and show you what I plan to do on how to change it starting right here with the communication program. So when you look into this with an open mind, an open heart, and consideration. Thank you.
Who are you? What exactly do you do?
I'm Jalen Hudgens, and I'm a jack of many trades, including communication major at Atlantic Cape, a basketball player at Atlantic Cape, a singer, dancer, rapper, music producer, writer, author of a children's book. I'm actually a radio host for 107.9 WRML, which is a show called Faith Time, which is actually also at Atlantic Cape. I'm a member of four clubs here, including Radio Club, Communication Club, Atlantic Cape Crew, and Media Productions, which I am the vice president of. I'm a mentor, a spokesperson for autism awareness, a minister in training at the Soar Church, where I am also on the praise and worship team, the men's ministry, and the assistant youth director for the youth ministry. I ran down a lot of my resume, and it might seem like a lot, but when it's all in the name of being positive and doing your best to be an influence, it's all worth it.
What is your motivation to be the person you are?
The younger people watching me. Everything I do essentially is for the youth, so that they can see that they are very capable of what people say is impossible, because that's ultimately what my testimony consists of. And I'm not saying I'm going to be the reason these kids live with purpose or that I'm going to be the best thing that ever happened to them, but I want to be an example of what it is to live out your wildest dreams despite your handicaps in life and despite the things you have to fight with to reach your full potential. You know, I believe anybody can, you know, receive that message, but I think the most important audience to reach is our youth, because they are our future, and a lot of them need a consistent role model in their lives to strive in ways that they never knew they could. And that's why I believe God has given me the ability to connect with children so well and so naturally, because I think it's part of my calling to be that consistent role model.
Where do you think your talents and gifts come from?
God. That's all there is to that. I don't mean to sound preachy, but if it isn't the grace of God holding me, I don't know what it is.
What makes you want to be the communication major of the year?
I feel as if, you know, not necessarily for my personal gain, but to promote the idea that people in the world who are facing obstacles designed to stop them from being what they want to be are capable of achieving success in major ways if they apply themselves and keep God first. Personally, the biggest obstacles that I faced were in the form of Asperger's syndrome and pervasive developmental disorder. At the age of 4 years old, I was medically diagnosed with both disabilities, and according to the doctor, they were supposed to stop me from being able to socialize, play team sports, and efficiently communicate. Yet, as I grew older, I have eventually proven every one of those doctor's claims wrong by using my gifts to inspire other people, becoming one of the captains for Atlantic Cape's basketball team for the past 2 years, and all the events leading up to me being nominee for Communication Major of the Year. However, just because it just so happens to involve me doesn't mean that it's about me or my testimony. It's more about the message behind the testimony. And that message is saying, no matter what you face in life, you're capable of surpassing and conquering whatever stands in your way, as long as your faith and your work ethic is there. The prestigious honor will be used as another platform to spread that message of hope to people, and I will also use it to show the world how much of that hope the communication program at Atlantic Cape has given me.
and to show everybody what, you know, how wonderful this program truly is. So again, it's not about me, but it's more about the positivity behind the platform and the idea of showing people that the only time your dream is too small is when you don't feel the need to fight for it.
Thank you very much.
At this time, we would like to welcome back all of our Communication Major of the Year nominees, Evan Fisher, Gianna Malgieri, Rachel Dougherty, Maria Gonzalez, and Jalen Hudgens.
Please join us again in giving them one more round of applause for their hard work and dedication to the COM program here at Atlantic Cape.
Now that you have heard from all of our Communication Major of the Year nominees, you will have the opportunity to vote for the student who you think should be the next Communication Major of the Year. Voting will go as follows. You all received a program at the door when you walked in. Inside each program is a ballot with the names of all the nominees. You will select the corresponding box of the nominee you select. You will have a few minutes before the ballots are collected and tabulated by faculty members, and we will announce the winner at the end of the show.
We're going to give our nominees yet again one more round of applause. And thank you. You guys may exit the stage. Coming up in the second half, we have Pete Thompson, some more awards, the Alumni of the Year winner, and your 2019 Communication Major of the Year. Also, who do you guys think are the top 10 musical artists of all time? Find out when we return, and feel free to stretch, walk around, and enjoy the slideshow.
To navigate the college jungle, we can all use a little help. Hi, I'm Keith Forrest, Associate Professor of Communication.
And I'm Jenny Thomas, Senior Adjunct Professor of Communication and English. We're also the co-advisors to the Communication Club, and both of us are also parents.
Yeah, we actually have a lot of darn kids, 7 between us. I have 4, Jenny has 3. And my son Cameron is about to start college in August. I don't know how the hell that happened.
We know it takes a village to carve our path through the college jungle and to help us succeed. Every person here getting a communication award tonight has had a little help along the way.
As professors, we get to take custody of your kids for a few years and get to watch them change and evolve. But we're not the only ones providing a little help and guidance.
Their peers, counselors, advisors, and sometimes even total strangers help them, but mostly all family. We need to recognize some important helpers in our audience tonight who are sharing in the journey that got you up here on the stage.
We would like to all the parents in the audience to stand. Come on, Mom and Dad, stand up. So tonight's show is also about you, for all you taught your kids, for the checks you wrote and are probably still writing, and for all your love and support.
We're sure that you are immensely proud of your sons and daughters tonight, So let's thank all the parents for all that they've done. And we gave them an enthusiastic round of applause.
Thanks for giving us a few minutes to express what a pleasure it's been to work with your sons and daughters.
We feel like the future is truly in capable hands. Can we please have Group 5 to line up now? And now, can you please join us in welcoming former NBC 40 sports producer Pete Thompson to the stage.
Hi, good evening, everybody. That's sports director. I earned that title. Thank you very much. Yes, my name is Pete Thompson, and in September, oh, they told me 5 minutes. Hang on, let me start this clock here. In 5 minutes, I'll give you a little spiel about my life, my career, and I'm really honored to be here because at one point I was you, the students, certainly, that are sitting here in the audience. I was fortunate to be the sports director of TV 40 from 2004 to 2014, but my story begins way before that. It certainly begins at the academic level, and in September, I'll be very fortunate to hit an anniversary, a 25-year anniversary of covering local sports on television, radio, and print. So I grew up in the Plymouth Meeting area just outside of Philadelphia. I went to Temple University. I went to Plymouth White Marsh High School first, Temple University second, and I have my Temple tee here to match my maroon. What a gift Temple was for me to instantly connect me with people and my passion like I see tonight. I met Gary Papa, the late Gary Papa from Channel 6 Action News. Gary was my mentor, Gary was my friend, and I saw what he did. I mean, I had done print, I had done radio up to that point, but I saw what he did and I said, I wanna do that. And I had no idea how difficult that journey and that road would be. So if there's one message I'll probably come back to a couple times in my brief time up here talking, it'll be, there will be obstacles in your way, but don't let them stand in your way. For example, a Plymouth Meeting kid ends up in Nebraska. That was my first job. I don't know if any of you have seen the movie Dances with Wolves, but when you got out to Western Nebraska, which was where I was, that's what it looked like. In town, it was a regular town. Outside of town, as far as you could see, nothing. I'll never forget, I went to an Eagles game not long before I started my job, and that was like on a Monday night, and by a Thursday, I was going to Denver, just throwing everything in a bag that I could, getting out there. I got to the station, and I said to the boss, where are the news vans? Because I'd always seen, there goes that Action News van. And they didn't have them. They said, you use your car. I said, well, I didn't bring a car. Well, you're going to be in trouble then. So I had to rent a car the first month I was there. These are obstacles that will go in your way. I had three jobs in Nebraska. I was at KDUH, and yes, if you put the call letters together, that's KDUH. I worked at KLKN TV in Lincoln, and I worked for KPTM Fox 42 in Omaha. And when I got fired from Fox 42 in Omaha and in communications, that'll happen sometimes, not because of your work, again, another obstacle, not because of anything you've done. Personalities clash, new boss comes in, wants his person in there, bing, bang, boom, that's all they wrote, right? So that happens sometimes. I worked for a Walgreens. You know, life really hits you when people come in and say, aren't you the sports guy? And you say, paper or plastic, right? Can I help you find anything else? I transferred from a Walgreens in Omaha to a Walgreens in King of Prussia, right about the time my brother got divorced. Moved in with him, my rent went to zero, my pay went up, and then I heard about this little TV station down by Atlantic City that somehow I missed when I graduated Temple, and that's how I ended up at TV 40 and was able to be there for a decade. So, wonderful time for me doing the Friday Night Blitz. I spent time with SNJ Today, which also has recently shut operations, but I know I've seen Michelle in the slides here, and Nor'easter Nick was here last year. They're trying to work on something called SJN. I continue to stay involved media-wise with 97.3 ESPN, which means the joke that I've been making for 20 plus years that I have a face for radio is now actually true. But I'm so thankful. I mean, the people that I've met along the way, you know, in September of 1994, I got to go see Harry Callis. And I said, Harry, I got a job. And oh, Peter, hello, Peter, how are you? That's great. You know, I've shaken the hands of three presidents. Who gets to do that? People in communications, when you're up front. I've met Bradley Cooper. I've met movie stars. I've met actors and actresses. I've interviewed famous people, but I've interviewed people that are working at Sister Jean's Kitchen, for example. That all comes from communications. That all comes from being able to communicate. And I've really come full circle because I'm now, just this year, teaching down the road real close here at ACIT. So I'm certainly encouraging my media students to look at ACCC as their next step. This is the right next step for a lot of our students. So keep doing what you're doing here. I'll wrap up by saying this. I've been very honored to spend some time with you. If there is anyone in this room, this is the secret, and I know everybody that gave their speeches to be the communication major of the year. Certainly at Temple I found this, but in here I think I sense it in the room. Help each other out. It's a competitive business, I get that, but help each other out. And I'll make this offer on an open microphone. If there's anyone in this room tonight, next month, next year, the year after, moving forward, that needs some help from me, there is a 25-year Rolodex in my head of contacts that I have. I'm currently trying to help a guy that was an intern with us, who worked with us, get from WJLA and ABC 7 in Washington, D.C. to Action News, behind the scenes, but I'm trying to get him there. I have a friend in Baltimore. My friend Kevin Nagandi is a Temple grad who is the first Indian-American anchor for ESPN. So use me. Come up to me afterwards. I'll be glad to stay in touch with you and help any of you out however I can. I thank you so much for the time. The timer went off. Good night, everybody.
At this time, we would like to present the Mass Media Film and Television Awards. The awards for Best Film History Group, Annalise Davis, John Donnelly, Zachary Fernandez, Evan Fisher, John Hartshorn, Megan Nickerson, Nick Rollins, Ryan Tomlinson, and Jennifer Johnston. Jennifer Johnston is also receiving an award for Best Film History Achievement. And the award for Best Film History Paper, Christopher Robertson. Thank you, everyone. You may now exit the stage.
On to Best Mass Media Project, Natalie Arch, Annie Becker, Spencer Monholland, Laura DeBloy. Laura DeBloy is also receiving awards for Best Mass Media Achievement, Best Mass Media Paper, and Best TV History Achievement.
The award for Best TV History Paper, Christina Kane. For Best TV History Project, Nick Rollins, Megan Nickerson, and Quinn Scholl. Thank you, everybody. You may now exit the stage. The award for Best Visual Communication Paper, Michael Adams. For Best Editing, John Maggio. The award for Communication Club, Jennifer Johnston. The award for Radio Club, Chris Lane. And the award for Best Interpersonal Group, Joanne Noto.
Thank you, everyone. You may now exit the stage. Please join us in welcoming to the stage the president of the Communication Club, John Donnelly.
First of all, I would like to thank all of those in attendance, and I hope that you're enjoying the show this evening. For this year's award show, our club decided it would be fun to poll students and faculty to find out who they believe are the top 10 greatest musical acts of all time. I will now present to you those results in a short video with some accompanying music from each artist and band.
Never lost control.
I would like to take this time to thank the faculty of who helped make this award show a success year in and year out, especially Professor Forrest, Professor Thomas, and Professor Boone. I would also like to thank my fellow peers who, through hard work and dedication, have helped to make this year's Communication Awards another resounding success. Most importantly, I would like to thank our Vice President, Jennifer Johnston. Without her tireless effort and her commitment to the club, as well as the communication program, none of this would have been possible. I am proud to have been a part of this club, this program, and this award show. I am also excited to see a new group of communication students step up and become the next generation of leaders for our illustrious program and club. Thank you. I would now like to welcome Briar Gibbons back to the stage.
Dedicated, humble, benevolent, perseverant. These are just a few ways that I like to describe this year's Alumni of the Year, Ken Kin. I remember listening to Ken give his speech as he was vying for Communication Major of the Year. I stood right over there. He had specific ideas about integrating the communication clubs on campus and how he would accomplish these goals using his platform as Communication Major of the Year. After Ken won, he set the standard for Communication Major of the Year nominees. Gone were the stand-up comedy routines and the indie movie submissions, and on to the era of telling the audience why you deserve to win and what you plan to accomplish with the role. But Ken didn't stop invoking change there. He led by example, and he used his platform to accomplish what he set out to do and more. Ken mentored fellow students and oftentimes led them outside their comfort zones, and he pushed them to push themselves. At least that's what I know Ken did for me. Through leadership and mentoring, Ken paved the way for future Communication Majors of the Year, giving us all a platform to stand on and turning the award from a title into an honor. I'm thankful to know someone like Ken, and I'm even more thankful to call him my friend. And so on behalf of the Communication Alumni Council, I'm proud to present the 2019 Alumni of the Year, Ken Kin.
Sorry, no cause for alarm, ladies and gentlemen. I just wanted to make sure something like this doesn't happen. Well, almost that. How you doing tonight? Awesome, man. You're doing a very good job. Thank you. Give her a hand. Give her a hand. So you remember Carrie, right? She got caught up in believing the unbelievable, didn't she? I mean, high school wallflower all of a sudden has friends, but not just any friends, popular kid friends. Then she's being escorted to the prom by the greatest American hero. And finally, she's queen of the prom. Well, it didn't turn out too well for Carrie. It's a little too good to be true. And it's a little too good to be true for me tonight, ladies and gentlemen. And it's how I've felt many times here at Atlantic Cape. I was shy and quiet like Carrie. And to go on to win 11 Communication Awards and be the 2012 Communication Major of the Year, to be the class valedictorian in 2014, and now the 2019 Communication Alumni of the Year, I'm sorry, but that's all just a little too good to be true, don't you think? Are you sure there's nothing up there? Because I don't know. Now, just like Carrie, I was the victim of an elaborate hoax that Atlantic Cape played on me. That's right, the students, faculty, and staff were all involved. I'm going to tell you the punchline at the end of the speech. Oh, yeah, the speech. I've been coming to the Comm Awards since 2011 when I won my first award. And the traditional Alumni of the Year speech would have me tell you a short story or an anecdote or two, maybe mentioning someone who had an impact on me while I was here, what I've done since leaving the college, and how my experiences here helped me with those future endeavors. Well, I'm not going to do that tonight, ladies and gentlemen, and it's not a knock at my predecessors. I am humbled and honored to be another link in their chain, but I just don't think I could summarize my experiences here with one or two little stories, dropping one or two names, and feel that I've done justice to all of the entities involved with my success. After all, I didn't do this alone. There are five different groups involved in the success. There's the students, faculty, and staff of Atlantic Cape. There's home support like family and friends, and the student himself, in this case, me. Let's take a look at them in reverse order, shall we? Because I am my own favorite topic, right, dude? My sister Janice, everyone. Sure, she had a smart aleck comment to make there. Now, ever since I was a teenager, my motto has been work hard, play hard. It's a paraphrase of a Theodore Roosevelt quote that goes, when you play, play hard. When you work, don't play at all. Teddy's a hero of mine, and I brought that work hard, play hard attitude with me here to Atlantic Cape. I also wanted the full college experience, so I was open to the opportunities that came along. As far as the home front, well, I've got that covered. Among the many family members, relatives, and friends, I would like to point out again my sister Janice, who you already met, and my wife Heidi. True story, before we were married, anytime the subject of marriage came up, I would tease Heidi with a line from a Woody Allen movie, A Midsummer Night's Sex Comedy. In it, the Tony Roberts character believes that marriage is the death of all hope. Now that's a horrible thing to say to your significant other, right? Now she knew I was joking, didn't really believe it, but it did bother her from time to time. And quite naturally, well, last October, we celebrated our 20th wedding anniversary, 29 years together total. Thank you. It's all her. So I just want to say publicly, with all of you as witnesses, Max's Cracker Jack TV crew filming all this, that in the 30 years now that Heidi's been in my life, I've known that anything and everything are possible. So thank you, Heidi. And as for me, well, I'm still just trying to impress my dream girl. So... Now, the staff of Atlantic Cape, they play their part, and not just in their day-to-day jobs, but by going above and beyond. And then-President Dr. Peter Mora led by example, who's always ready, willing, and eager to be involved with the students, and even honored the TV club in 2013 by asking us to film his State of the College address, which had previously been outsourced. Chelsea Peasy, who is then the social media director at Atlantic Cape, who first approached me about creating the Atlantic Cape News Minute. And Wendy Gray from the Career and Academic Planning Center, who was always a good friend to the News Minute. So why do the staff go above and beyond this way? Because they believe in the institution. They believe in the parts they play within the system. And they believe in the students here to learn, grow, and succeed. The faculty members of Atlantic Cape, of course, play a big part as well. I would do just about anything for Professors Keith Forrest and Joy Jones, the two co-chairs of the Communication Department while I was here. I had three classes with each of them and pivotal moments with each as well. towards the end of my first semester here, after class one day, Keith Forrest says, Ken, I want you in my Journalism 2 class next semester. I said, but Keith, I haven't had Journalism 1 yet. It's okay, it doesn't matter. Well, it might be okay for you, but I think I need one before 2. No. You have to be in that class. You need to be in that class. If you know Keith, you kind of get that. I figured if a professor is inviting you to be in a class, you really shouldn't say no. And it was pivotal as two of the pieces I wrote for that class were published in the Cape May County Herald and the Press of Atlantic City and garnered me my first COM award. Fast forward about a year after class with Joy Jones one day, with her Kentucky drawl, my first and last names were the same, King Kin. So she said, King Kin, why aren't you running for COM Major of the Year? And we discussed it, and she gave me some things to think about. And by the end of that evening, I had thrown my hat into the ring. So pivotal moments again here as part of my Atlantic Cape experience. And Professors Keith Forrest and Joy Jones are still good friends and mentors to this day. I'd also like to throw out the names of Professor Heather Boone and Rich Gibbons, both big-time fans of everything Ken Kin while I was here. I had two classes with each of them and wish it could have been more. These professors drew out strengths in me that I either didn't know I had or had never bothered to scratch. And they go above and beyond as well. Rich Gibbons has been an advisor for clubs here many times over the years. And Professor Boone Well, she runs a tight ship backstage at these Comm Awards every year. So how about a hand for Heather and all the backstage people? And let's not forget all of the faculty and staff members who do go above and beyond by being the advisors for the many clubs, organizations, and sports teams here on campus. Here I'd like to throw out the names of Jim Taggart, Bo Zilovich, and Rich Russell, the advisors for the Radio Club, TV Club, and Rewrites Literary Magazine, respectively. Rich Russell also runs a yearly writing colloquium, another outlet for the students' creativity, one I was honored to be a part of for 2 years. Why do the faculty go above and beyond this way? Because they too believe in the institution, the parts that they play, and the students here to learn, grow, and succeed. And that leads us to last, but certainly not least, my fellow students. I've often said that I've learned just as much from them as I did from the classes I was in. They are probably the biggest reason for my successes here. There are far too many to mention, which is why I brought the photographic support. But I do need to shout out to Darian, John, and Chrissy at the Radio Club, who made me feel so welcome from the very start. Everyone who assisted with the Atlantic Cape News Minute and made that the success that it was. Max and Dino and everyone at the TV Club who said, Ken, come play with us too, and opened yet another door for me here at Atlantic Cape. The class that I'm mentoring now for Professor Forrest here, the students in that class, they blow me away as well. They rock. If any of you are here, you're the greatest. So, but two students bear special mention, Jessica Garazzi and Briar Gibbons. The two have not only been big friends, fans, and supporters over the years, even after Atlantic Cape, but have grown to have special places in my heart. The students have even given me my own slogan, Ken Kin or Die. Ken Kin or Die. And I think that might be my most cherished award here at Atlantic Cape because it's the last one I would have expected. And something else I didn't expect was, while I knew that we would work and play together in classes and clubs, I really didn't expect to form any meaningful, long-lasting friendships here. You know, what with being old enough to be their older brother and all. So, but boy, was I wrong. And let's face it, without the acceptance of my fellow students, these things just don't happen. So like I said, I did not do these things alone. And this award is not a symbol of my success, but rather our success. The students, faculty, and staff of Atlantic Cape, my home support crowd, and me, all working and playing together. Oh, and that joke that they played on me, well, you know, they got me so involved with the clubs and activities and awards that I forgot my original goal of a career in radio. They distracted me so much. I graduated, still didn't know what I wanted to be when I grew up. So anyway, to our award winners tonight, congratulations. I hope that as you show off your trophies over the coming days and weeks, or years like me, that you will remember to give credit where credit is due. And that when you look at your awards, as I do with mine, you'll see the faces of the people who helped make it possible. Because in the end, that's what really matters. The people with you in the sandbox, drawing out your strengths and helping you to learn, grow, and succeed. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you, Atlantic Cape, for showing me that sometimes things that seem too good to be true actually are true. Thank you.
Could group six please begin to line up?
We are here to hand out two awards to some very deserving faculty members. Chip Garrison has been a teacher at Absagami since 1990 and also has also produced countless plays. He's ran the Stockton Day Camp for several years for many children, and he's also assisted with the daily operation of Gami TV. He's helped numerous students break out of their shells and perform at the level they never thought they could. From Spamalot to Shakespeare, he supplies students the opportunity to grow as an actor and as a young adult. We present you with this as a thank you. You can come accept your award.
Sorry. Thank you. When I was in my first year of college and I decided to major in education in speech communications, English, and theater, my academic supervisor, Dr. Dennis Klinzing, who was the department chairperson for the School of Communications and Theater at Westchester University, said in very clear words something which I still carry with me to this day. Don't teach if you think you should be doing something else. You gotta love it. Only teach if that is truly what you want to do. I've been lucky enough to want to teach for the past 29 years of my life. And I've been lucky enough to get the opportunity to teach in a school which has allowed me to work with students both at the classroom and on stage and explore so many means of communication, expression, and art. My principal, Dr. Jerry Lynn Vernon, who is here tonight, likes to say that teenagers are her favorite people, and I readily concur. Their constant, borderline, out of control, ubiquitous energy, and endless capacity to surprise both themselves and the world, it's what they can achieve when they put their mind and heart to it. It never ceases to amaze me what they can do. When you walk into my classroom, I have a little sign under my clock that reads, transcend mediocrity. I hit them with the big words right away, as soon as they walk in. I draw attention to that sign every year so that everyone who comes into my class sees it. It's my way of telling my students to go beyond whatever limitations that they may have set for themselves and to conquer whatever obstacles they believe the world has placed in front of them. I want to thank everyone here at Atlantic Cape for this honor. The program here is absolutely wonderful, and you are all to be congratulated for the excellent work that you do. I want to thank my fellow teachers at Apsicami High School. I want to thank Dr. Vernon and the building administration of Apsicami High School. And of course, I want to thank the now generations of students who I have been lucky enough to work with. Students like Gianna and Briar and Max and Chance and Jenna. These are students who have taught me far more than I could have ever possibly taught them. And finally, I want to thank my wife, Lois, and my daughter, Colleen. We who teach, we pay a price when it comes to our time that we can spend with our families. Long school days, grading papers at night, meetings, rehearsals, lots and lots and lots of rehearsals. My wife and daughter they've loved me and supported me this entire time through my entire career. And this award tonight is proof that I'm a tremendously lucky man. Thank you.
Well, I'm here tonight to discuss David Ron Rome, who from this moment on I will refer to as Mr. Rome, as that is how I know him. But as I've spoken before, in high school, I was drawn to film. And through that, I eventually left Mainland after 2 years and moved on to Charter Tech. And there, specifically in the film department, I would find Mr. Rome as my instructor. And when I first showed up, I was much more interested in just filming things. Like, I'll be a weatherman cameraman, you know, I'll be in the news studio just with a camera. I didn't super care that much. It was more about the technical side to me. But over my 2 years at Charter Tech, as I slowly went from the intermediate to the advanced film group, Mr. Rome would show me films and show me how to analyze them and deconstruct them, and I actually understood it. So through his teaching and through his lessons, I've been able to get where I am now with understanding media and analyzing it and creating my own as not just a technical piece, but something that says things and means things on a deeper level that you have to understand and deconstruct. So through that, I'd like to present this award to Mr. Rome and give him a few minutes to talk and say his thoughts about things. So Mr. Rome, if you could come out.
Thank you.
I didn't prepare much, but I started filming when I was like in 1975 when my grandfather gave me his camera, and I've been teaching about 16 years now, and this is a lot of cool things that happened, and this is about the coolest. I mean, to have one of your students, you know, ask you to do something like this, it's a really an honor. So thank everybody for having me, and the last guy said everything I was going to say anyway. Thank you.
I will now be taking the time to present the Mentoring and Alumni Pioneer Awards to a select group who have proven themselves as excellent educators and students by demonstrating great enthusiasm and dedication to the communication program. For the Mentoring Awards, Dino Arantoulis. Carly Buddy. Chris Cardo, Jenna DeLuca, Lori Gunther, and Taylor Henry. Taylor Henry is also receiving an Alumni Pioneer Award. How about a hand? How about a nice hand?
Nice job.
Congratulations.
Thanks.
Further mentoring awards. Maritza Kojai. Rachel Scott. Katie Waitman. Gabby Wyand. And Nicole Mingo. Nicole Mingo is also receiving an Alumni Pioneer Award. Congratulations, everyone. You can see here's at the stage. For our faculty pioneer, Evangelos E.J. Botsis. Our staff pioneers, Dennis Jones. And Nancy Porfido. Now for our alumni pioneers, Briar Gibbons, Chris Devine, and Kyle Schachner. Thank you, everyone. You may exit the stage. Next, I will be presenting the Student Pioneer Awards to a select group of students who have shown great commitment and leadership in the Communication Department. Student Pioneers, John Donnelly, Jennifer Johnston, Nick Rollins. Nick Rollins is also receiving the Volunteer Service Award. And our Outstanding Academic Achievement, Laura DeBloy. get your pictures. How about a nice hand as they exit the stage? Congratulations. Thank you.
Back out. Are they coming back out? Okay, we're about to have the big moment that we've all been waiting for, the announcement of this year's Communication Major of the Year. So we're going to bring them all back out, right? Okay, we're going to bring them all back out, all five of them. You're going to do this part?
I thought you guys were announcing.
Okay. We're gonna have you first. Start over. All right. We have Nick and Meg.
Hello and good evening. Let us take a moment to give applause to all the students who have received awards tonight. Let us also take a moment to thank our hosts this evening, Briar Gibbons, Chris Devine, and Jenna DeLuca. Also, our Alumni of the Year, Ken Kin. A special thanks to David Von Rome, Charles Garrison, Pete Thompson, and the faculty and staff who were able to make it to tonight's show. Lastly, give a round of applause to you in the audience, family, friends, and alumni who have come together to help make tonight special. You have viewed performances by five outstanding communication majors in their hopes of becoming the 2019 Communication Major of the Year.
At this time, I would just like to thank all of the communication majors for putting the hard work and dedication it takes to doing this event. Without your hard work and leadership, new communication majors would not have any chance. Well, I wouldn't want to say that. Would not have anybody to look to. You are the leaders, and I encourage you to take on multiple responsibilities within the comm program. The best times I had at Atlantic Cape were the most chaotic. Although my time as SGA president was stressful, it was an important role to play within my student community. So please be the leaders I know you can be, and I would also like to thank my girlfriend, Catherine Schaefer, for being here and for making the track down from Rhode Island that took about 12 hours. So thank you. Thank you all, and thank you all for coming.
Now please join me in welcoming the nominees back to the stage. Evan Fisher, Gianna Malgieri, Rachel Dougherty, Maria Gonzalez, and Jalen Hudgens.
And please welcome back Jenny Thomas and Keith Forrest.
So you're probably wondering who won. Are you wondering? Because we have to go to a commercial break first. Let's see. Okay. So I have the honor of announcing the Communication Major of the Year runner-up. The Communication Major of the Year runner-up is Rachel Dougherty.
I get to say the winner. All right. Our 2019-2020 Communication Major of the Year is Jalen Hudgens. Congratulations.
Thank
All right, thank you, everyone. Thank you for coming.
You don't have to go home, but you can't.